Hey everybody, I'm Robert and I'd like to welcome you down here to Blackfish Graphics where we're sitting in front of a V6 Cayman. That's interesting because it's a car the boys just went and picked up this morning and brought down to Blackfish because it's going to be getting an Apex livery for the 2020 VLN race series. So this is something that we're really, really excited to announce to you guys. Something we're, I think, pretty pumped about for ourselves as well.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, we went through with the Blackfish team and laid out a pretty cool design that we think works for us and works for our style. But more than anything, we wanted to present it to you guys, let you know what's going on, because over the last 3 years now, it's been, hey, when's Apex Racing going to start? Hey, when's this going to happen? Can I race with you guys? Can we come down and watch you? Can we taxi with you guys on VLN Friday? What's going on? It's always been, yeah, not yet, not yet, not yet. My big goal was really all along to develop Apex. You know, in the first year, you'll remember it was, I want, you know, rental cars to take off. The second year was, I want taxis to take off. The third year, I want optimization. I want the teams to be perfect and knowing their job and knowing the business and how we deal with the customers and how we deal with problems. And I feel like we've finally gotten to that point where we can say, all right, the team's in a really good position and we can go forward. For the 2020 season, I had a lot of different ideas and a lot of different plans. And this was one of them that's been able to come to fruition. And it's one that I think with the right teams and the right partners, we're able to do without taxing the Apex rental and taxi hotel team, if you would, because that's really been my biggest concern, was about taking something away from Apex itself. So this year we were able to put a plan together. Luis has done a lot of work organizing and planning and getting everything set up. And we're finally at a point where we can make this a reality. And it's something I'm excited to build on and grow on. So if you guys couldn't tell, these two guys are going to be driving the car.
Yes, we are.
Something that was also really important for me with this level of racing here was to make it an Apex team. You know, we really wanted it to be an internal team and something that could represent Apex in a certain way. The very, very important to have a design on the car, you know, that represented Apex, and if Apex's name was going to be on it, had to kind of go in a certain way, and it had to represent us. So something I'm really personally proud about is to say that this car right here will race on Saturdays in VLN, and then Saturday evening and Sunday you can actually get in with the same guys and do some taxi laps. So in the other cars, so I think that's pretty exciting. But I'll turn over to these guys a little bit. You guys can tell me maybe a little bit about what are your goals for the season? What does this season mean to you? Racing, I think, you know, first of all, in a Cayman, you know, is pretty exciting. But tell me a little bit about what you think. Who wants to take it?
Yeah, I'll kick off. I mean, super excited to sort of get behind the wheel for VLN again. Last year was sort of my debut year in VLN, as it were. Obviously, done a lot of racing in the past. Always wanted to start doing it again as soon as possible. Last year, did a few races in the 240s alongside yourself, different teams but same championship. And this year in the 240, in the Cayman.
Right.
And never even driven a Cayman before. But from what I've figured out already, and you know, from the GT2 and all that sort of stuff, right. Yeah, I'm really excited to get started.
You can feel the Porsche brand. It has its weight because of one single thing, and that's they are amazing to drive. It's really, really cool car. I'm really excited because it's like something that we have been working on for a while. It's not just like we decided today that we're gonna make it. It's something that we have been working. We have been working with different brands to see if they want to be part of it, to make it big, not just like to look like any other race car there.
Right.
Our plans is like to have really good results, of course. We are training, we have been training for that. The taxi has given us a lot of the training that we need also, because you get used to traffic in different ways, you get used to the conditions that we have here.
Right.
So that gives us, I think, a step forward that can help us soon.
I think for you guys that's pretty neat with the amount of laps that you're getting in the taxis.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, obviously there's a big difference. A lot of people, I've actually been asked before regarding Moritz, for example, people have said, oh, I want to know if Moritz feels that he's gotten faster because he's driving the taxi. And the answer from Moritz was like, no, you know, it obviously slows you down a little bit, because when you're in the taxis driving, you're holding back and your rhythm is completely different than when you're all out. And especially Moritz is driving a cup car, you know, and so he's got a little bit more downforce he's dealing with and things like that. So his corner speeds are much, much higher. So when you jump into the taxis, you're actually holding back and you're getting in a completely different rhythm and a completely different mindset.
It works both ways as well. I often find that when you go from the taxi into the race car, it takes you sometimes three quarters to a full lap to be like, hang on, you know, let's go.
But on the other side, Moritz, I was just casually talking with him about this one day as well, and he said, you know what, but one thing that did happen, he said, is I had a very good story from one race where I was driving and the track was wet and I was on rain tires, and because I'd done so many laps in the taxi,
for sure,
I knew exactly how quick this track was going to dry. I went in before anybody else, I put on my slicks,
and you know, great ground. You learn the sort of everything, the geographic of the of the track, and where it's going to dry out quicker, and exactly where on the track it might dry out, or where it's going to rain first, and all that sort of stuff. So there's no question that there is a skill set that sort of transfers.
So I think for us, another thing that was really key was tying in the Apex rental cars, the Apex taxis, and then the Apex racing program. That was very, very important for us to tie that all together. It was key to work with the same partners, whether it be tire manufacturer, braking systems, and things like that. That was very important for us to also bring that together. So we will be running a Nankang tire, which is a new tire for the VLN series. They started with it last year as well. So we'll be running on the Cayman V6, we'll be running the Nankang tire. And that's also very exciting for us, because just as we've been working very closely with Nankang on the development of other tires, we're going to get to do the same thing with their motorsport tire. And that's, I think, something
that's something
cool
really big. That's something really big, especially as a manufacturer for tires, to actually go onto a bigger part that is the racing.
Right.
I think that that's really, really cool.
Yeah.
And as we've been working with them for a while, that helps also.
I think it'll be neat, you know, to have that relationship with Nankang. And, you know, like we said, the goal is for us, as well as our sponsors in terms of Nankang and APP, is going to be working with us on braking systems as well, and things of that nature. They want to develop and they want to progress just the same way that we do. And I think that's leads to what the future holds, you know, for Apex Racing. Yeah. You know, there's definitely a very bright future in the sense that I believe that this can go much further than simply a V6 Cayman, you know what I mean? We've got some things in the works that we started and we're hoping to release this year, but I can't quite speak about it yet. But just due to certain things not coming together the way they needed to, it's gonna be a program for 2021, but it just leads to this development, you know? And for me, the whole racing program isn't something that I want to cap, and I don't think the drivers do either.
Nope.
You know, drivers get in a car and they do well, and they always want to progress. And I really do see the entire Apex Racing program going from even down to a BMW stock class, if you would, production series class, up to something like this V6 Cayman, and even going further, maybe next year, if the fortunes go our way, maybe we can find ourselves, in addition to what I just alluded to that can't quite talk about yet, but maybe even into a GT4 car, a Cayman Cup or something along those lines. That's also a possibility. And also introducing customer racing, you know? So I think that's also something that we can definitely do.
A lot of people would like to race, but they don't know how to do it.
Right.
So we're gonna give the people the tools.
Yeah, you make it more accessible, and you also share your knowledge with them.
Right.
You know, and you can tell them where the track dries out quickest, or you know, where to get on the gas and all that sort of stuff. You know, so it's an interesting prospect from every angle.
For me, I mean, my goal with the racing program is just I want to see people have fun. You know, I want to see these guys have fun. I want to see you guys watch it and enjoy it. Tom's going to be really following the progress of this. The livery is going to start actually this week and will be done in the next couple days. So I want to see these guys have fun. I want to have the Apex team being able to go out and enjoy watching the team race and actually lay the foundations for bigger things from the Apex Racing program. Really, that's what my biggest goal is. I don't have an expectation set as far as, okay, we have to win every race or we have to get, you know, any position. I just want to see everyone go out, have a good time, and learn this car, learn the entire season and the strategy, and really bring the whole thing together. you know, that's my main objective. I just want it to be enjoyable. Something I'm really excited about for everybody actually is that on Fridays, starting with VLN2, with VLN1, we're going to want to make sure we have seat time. We will be out at the testing day. I think that's the 14th of March.
Yeah, that's next week.
We'll be out at the testing day doing that. And then VLN1, we're going to take the practice session, obviously, to truly practice. But then starting with VLN2, we're going to offer taxi laps on Friday practice. So
it's a great experience as well. I mean, I did some taxi laps last year, and it's not like anything you could experience during TF.
Right.
Like, to have full-blown Factory Works GT3 cars come past is just, you know, it's a pretty cool experience.
Yeah. I've been telling people all along that it's something you need to do. You need to experience it. You know, any traditional taxi lap is one thing. You know, when you go out like in the GT2 RS built by Manti Racing, you know you're going to be in the fastest car on the track.
Yeah.
And it's amazing.
Yeah.
But you go out in a VLN race, and that, like you said, the GT3 car passes you like.
Yeah. And you know, and the thing is, you are going.
Practice. Yeah, you are going because you want to practice for the next day.
So yes, so everyone's, you know, driving flat out.
We don't need to hold at any point, unless the person is sick, of course.
but at any point,
we just go.
That's one of my excitement again, is to share it with people. You know, we've been doing VLN tours for 3 years now. This is our fourth year of doing VLN tours and taking people around. Now we actually get to take them around, show them our car. They get to see our car on the track while we're doing the tour. They get to come in the pits and see our drivers and say, what's it like out there? And actually, you know, communicate with the
team.
Well,
we can say afterwards, you'll come find out, because as soon as we're done with this, we're back out during tourist fun.
So it really does tie everything together, and that excites me, and that brings me a lot of joy, you know, hoping that everyone gets to come out, share in the fun, and see the car out there, that the people at home who have been literally asking for years, when are you guys going to start racing, now they see, okay, this is the year, you know. So really, in a matter of, I guess, 9 days, 10 days, we're on track.
Yeah,
you know, and that's pretty exciting. So yeah, so I mean, that's what we're doing for the 2020 season. I'm looking forward to sharing it with you guys, and as well as everyone that's going to be watching it. Like I said, Tom Stamp's going to be hardcore on the media in these guys' face as they get out of the car. They're going to have to climb over him. They have to climb over him to get out of the car. But yeah, really, I'm really pleased to be working on this and sharing with everybody, and likewise with you guys. So
yeah, no, I'm really excited. I can't wait to get started and start pumping out some good results.
Yes, let's push.
Let's do it. All right, guys, we'll see you later this year, huh?
See you later, guys.